on this special edition of The Crate, my bro Terrace Martin, I gotta give him some fire items that's inspired by Doritos Blaze. After he finished completing the beat, we're gonna put it up on DoritosBlazeTheBeat.com, download it, and spit that fire blaze to it for your chance to win. Let's do what we need to do.
Kuta, black man taking no loss.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I don't want your apple pie, mama.
Dorito Blaze.
Official.
Garlic. What's that? What we got over there? Hot sauce?
Hot sauce, rude boy.
You know where I'm from, and we put that on the chips. What else we got? What is this?
I don't know what that is, bro.
Oh, okay.
I guess that's the thing to make the beat extra fire.
Make it fire, make it hot. And this, what is a torch?
You ever made beats with any of this before, bro?
Never in my life, but I've used a few of these things.
A few of them things, right?
The torch. Just give me a click tempo. I'll do like 8-bar loops first with my mouth.
Okay.
Just the bottom of the drums, and I'm on the 67. You hear that?
This the first time I'm really watching this chemistry unfold with you, scientists.
But you know, ain't there's no instruments.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, so yeah, this is kind of mind blowing for me right now too.
Just us. Yeah, well, me too. I don't know what's gonna happen.
I never seen you where you put the formulas together. This is crazy.
That's the loop. Let me hear that. So we got the breakbeat down. We got the bottom. I'm gonna grab one of these pillows over here.
You believe it? Hold up. You about to bang on the.
Cause that's my kick, that's the break beat, so this the kick drum. And then, you know, I gotta use everything here.
This is the illest ever. This is so hip hop to me right now, though. This knocking on that table and rapping in school.
I'm gonna use this again for an instrument, but I'm gonna use this for now, just to silence this one little part. Cause it's making a little rattle noise. There we go, I think that little piece right there. There we go. No more rattle, right? So we putting a pole tech on this to
on
make
the
it
kick,
just
to just boom. Put the boom back yeah. Knock on it. Legendary pole tech. I don't know nothing about that, y'all gonna
hey,
learn.
How many records you did with the pole tech?
Every record that knocked the hardest from analog days. Oh, y'all getting a good school in the day.
I'm using the U47, cause you know, I always see people use these for vocal mics, but it's old pictures of like, Miles and Coltrane them, and the drummers using these mics and U87s on drums.
I've never recorded on nothing outside of U87.
Really?
Every vocal in my life.
Even Big Bang Theory? That wasn't C-Andrew G with Dr. Dre and them over there?
He tried to make me use that on 2 songs and it was frustrating me, so I said,
it was too bright for you, huh?
Too bright, bro.
Yeah.
He had me use it for Break Your Neck.
Yeah.
And he had me use it for this joint Holler that we did. The rest of the album is U87. Too
yeah, bright. Cause your tone is so powerful. It needs something to hold that bass and
thank you, bro.
That roundness.
Yeah, I needed that U87, man.
I'm ready. Oh, that's it. That's the sound. Detune what I just did, make it kind of low, and then turn it up. You never touch the red. None of them rules they taught y'all. None of them strange, expensive rules y'all all got. We gonna break all the rules today. I'm a Dr. Dre fanatic, and the percussion in the Death Row era, like on all them California Love songs, was a guy named Butch Smalls. His whole trap case of percussions was like weird cooking utensils and 2 pieces of plywood he would make claps with. He said he learned that from doing all the Parliament records. They would make claps with plywood. So then wow. I said, oh, Butch Smalls would take anything in here and make a percussion. So I just played with it enough till I figured out a sound. Loop that. I'm a Jay Dilla fan. He always had random,
oh, yeah.
Strange things,
oh, yeah.
That, you know, in his music tied together. So that's this sound. On the SSL, you can hear the high end is stripped with the filter on it. It's just, it's simple. It's dirty on purpose. Give me the C414. Fly that through the whole record. I'm bringing that in and out. That's gonna be like my kibasa,
cool.
Like my shaker energy.
I'm super interested to see what you're gonna do with the hot sauce bottle, though.
Me too. Me too. Mmm. The more liquid you pour, the higher the pitch go. Right now, I'm making the chord.
You get another note on top of that. Higher one than one low when I'm cool. Let me go to low note. Cool.
I'm gonna use the Doritos for like the bottom of the snare and rattle. The hip hop community has taken what we've had around and just made it happen. Because you know, when the school districts dried up all the black communities of instruments, all we was left was our parents' turntables and records. You know what I'm saying? And thank God, because the Tribe Called Quest, the No End Theory album, challenged me and gave me a different way of life.
Oh, nice, nice, nice.
They made me want to play instruments. So I'm doing nothing different than what they did. It's just we have a different set of tools. The second one.
Hell yeah. It don't get no roar in it. Yes. The rattle.
You know what's crazy? The first time I heard some crazy how they do that, the Big Bang Theory with the...
Oh, yeah. He talking about a song that me and Dre did on the Big Bang album called Legends of the Fall-Offs. Dre had a barrel of dirt, and he mic'd the floor, and he mic'd the barrel, inside the barrel. So he just went in there and just poured the dirt on the floor.
That's the whole concept.
The concept of the song is about when a career is really dead, but they don't know how to accept that. Dre literally made a beat that sounded like somebody was in a hole, in a coffin, and it was being covered by the dirt.
That was innovative.
That was all Dre, bro. I just came in the room. He made me write 3 songs of that beat, though, before he was happy. But I was so determined to not let, because I knew how I'd have felt if 50 or one of them would have got on it and made it a smash. And I was like, it was my beat first, and I didn't kill it. I couldn't accept that. And this was the last song we recorded for the album.
Wow. We should take them sounds.
We should take the whole beat, bro. You turning this to a record.
Give me like an over-exaggerated reverb, okay. And then under the reverb, you could go back to the Metal Flanger plugin and put like a chorus effect under the reverb. Turn the rate of the phaser up faster. Or make it Led Zeppelin intense. Okay. I'm gonna do another one with some fire coming out because it sounds like the tone's a little lower. That's the one. And I'm gonna get the mic and do some weird. Blaze. Cool. Pitch that voice way up like Minnie Mouse. And most producers back in the day didn't even play music. They just had enough sense to put the right people together to be a successful ride. Just because you walk into a studio and you play a keyboard and you write a part. Thank you. You wrote a part. You're part of the record, but you're not the producer just because you send the beat. I don't care how many sounds you put in it. You're not the producer. The producer is somebody that produces the whole situation and stays from the hi-hat to mastery.
So when y'all see him come over here, he already had the navigation system on. It was already up and running on how to reach the destination to bring the most successful moment out of the music. He giving me the flow pattern. It clicked right away. I'm like, you done tapped into a vibe. And I just caught the ghost.
The natural
shit. He did thumbs up, and then he left me. He went back over here. He was like, okay, he got it. All of y'all gonna do y'all freestyle, that's cool. When y'all finish, we gonna show you how you supposed to do it. As inspired as I am to want to rhyme on this, I just really hope that when September comes and it's time for y'all to touch this Doritos, you know, Blaze stage, y'all got y'all act together. I got more than one reason to be inspired to come with my bars that day. I'm trying to get to the bag too.
Bust some bust, baby. On some hip hop real with me. It was dope to be in a room with Busta Rhymes and no drum machine and get a record done.
Come on, what?
Nobody has done that! And he's gonna be Kimson, Taylor, Dre! And nobody has done that!
Nobody.
Woo, I shared a moment with Busta Rhymes. I'm in the book now, I'm sharing a moment.
What up, up, squad? I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, you can hit the subscribe button. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram by clicking the links below. Until next time, thanks for watching All Deaf Music.